Hello friends, this video on body movements part 6 is brought to you by examfear.com. No more fear from exam. So let us look at some examples of synovial joints. So one very common example is the ball and socket joint. So where do we have this ball and socket? So it is present in the shoulder. So in this region where complete rotation is allowed, that is due to the presence of the ball and socket joint. It is also present in the hip region here. Also you have ball and socket joint. So we will learn how exactly a ball and socket joint is and how it works. Another example could be pivotal joint or pivot joint. So this is present in atlas and axis. Now what are atlas and axis? So atlas and axis are the joints where neck is joined to the head. Now the connection, the link between neck and head is important. Because of that only we are able to move our head from side to side or from front to back. So those movements are possible because of the presence of the pivot joint. So this pivot joint, so these joints are given the special names atlas and axis. So those are the joints, those are the points where pivot joint is present. So in pivot joint what happens is it allows a rotatory movement around a single axis. So you see this is the axis and around this axis you can move it like this or you can move it like this. Third type of synovial joint is hinge joint, which is present in elbow. So if you look at the movement of elbow, that is little different from that of the shoulder. So from at shoulder, you can rotate it completely. But when you look at the elbow, you can just move it back and forth. So that is an example of hinge joint. So you see, if you compare hinge joint with ball and socket joint with this pivotal joint, you see that each of them allows different type of movements. With ball and socket joint, you can freely move it any way you want. With hinge joint, you can just move it back and forth. Whereas with pivot joint, you can move it in on a rotation basis, but around a fixed axis. So all of these are synovial joints. That is, in all of these there is enough joint cavity which is filled with the fluid, because of which flexible movements are allowed. So let us now talk about each of these joints in detail. So we'll start with ball and socket joint. The name is quite interesting. Why do we call it ball and socket? So here we have a ball shaped surface of one bone. So one end of one bone is in the shape of a ball, which fits into the cup-like depression of another bone. So basically you have one bone like this and you have another socket like this. So this bone fits into this socket. So that is why it is called ball and socket joint. So that's how the name came. Now since this ball-shaped bone fixes into this socket, so there is enough flexibility. So now this ball like structure can actually move the way it wants on that, within that socket. So something of this sort. So you have a socket like this, which is a part of the second bone, and this is the first bone, which has a ball like end at one end. So what happens, this ball fits into the socket. Now this is an example of ball and socket joints. As you can see here, this is the socket and this is the ball. So the ball will fit perfectly within the socket. Now since it is spherical in shape, so the ball will be able to move. So the ball is free to move like this. So here it can move like this. Here this ball can also move like this. So there is total flexibility of the movement of the ball, the movement of this bone, the movement within this socket. Now this allows movement in all directions. So that is the most important point of ball and socket joint. Now when you look at the movement of your shoulder, you see that you can move your arm the way you like at shoulder. So that is due to the ball and socket joint. Similarly, the bone, the joint which is present near your hip, where your thighs are joined to your pelvis, so that point also you can move it the way you want. So that is also an example of ball and socket joint. So let us look at the examples. So the first example would be around hip. So the rounded head of the bone which forms the ball basically. So when you look at it, this is the rounded head, which is the ball, and it fits into this socket, which is nothing but a cup-shaped socket. That bone is called acetabulum. So this cup-shaped socket is called acetabulum. That is the name of the bone. Whereas this ball-shaped rounded head of the bone, this is called femur. So this femur bone fits into the acetabulum. Similarly, this is also seen in case of shoulder. There also the rounded head of humerus. So this bone, the upper bone of the arm is called humerus. So this upper bone is humerus. So the rounded head of humerus fits into a socket like this. So this socket is nothing but the socket of the shoulder blade. So here also the humerus bone, rounded head of the humerus bone fits into the shoulder blade. So because of which the bone can move the way it wants within that ball. So that is why you see you can freely make movements. You can not only rotate your arm at the shoulder, you can also move it sideways, you can also move it up and down. So movements of all types are allowed wherever ball and socket joint is present. So here the socket. What is the socket? What is the purpose of having the socket? Now, due to the presence of the socket, you have a cavity. The socket is nothing but a cavity. So, the presence of this fluid-filled cavity allows so much of flexible movements.
Thank you. Please visit www.examfeo.com to watch more educational videos with a better experience. Please do not forget to like and subscribe to our YouTube channel for latest updates. Thank you once again.